पहिल्या प्रकारची जी सेल डिव्हिजन आहे त्याला आपण मायटॉसिस म्हणतो. मायटॉसिसमध्ये आपण पाहिलेलं आहे की पॅरेंट सेलमध्ये जो क्रोमोझोम नंबर असतो तोच क्रोमोझोम नंबर डॉटर सेल्समध्ये सुद्धा तुम्हाला आढळेल. म्हणजे याच्यामध्ये क्रोमोझोम नंबर इज केप्ट कॉन्स्टंट इन द डॉटर सेल्स ॲज डॅट ऑफ ए पॅरेंट सेल, अँड डॅट्स वाय दिस इज कॉल्ड अ इक्वेशनल टाईप ऑफ सेल डिव्हिजन. दुसऱ्या जी प्रकारची सेल डिव्हिजन आहे दिस इज कॉल्ड ॲज मियोसिस. दिस मियोसिस टर्म वॉज कॉइंड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाईम बाय जे बी फार्मर इन द इयर 1905. देन आफ्टरवर्ड्स दिस टर्म इज कॉमनली यूज्ड. दिस टाईप ऑफ सेल डिव्हिजन इट ऑकर्स इन द रिप्रोडक्टिव सेल्स. And this produces haploid daughter cells. Meiosis it occurs in the reproductive cells during the gamete formation. Gametes are haploid. It occurs in the reproductive cells during the gamete formation. In this case, chromosome number is reduced to half. If you consider a diploid reproductive cell, from this diploid reproductive cell, in the first step, two haploid cells are produced, and in the next step, four haploid cells are produced. Means, in the entire process of meiosis, four haploid cells or the four haploid gametes are produced from a diploid cell. Thus, chromosome number is reduced to half. That's why this is called as reductional type of cell division. This produces four haploid gametes. Meiosis term was coined for the first time by J.B. Farmer. It occurs in the reproductive cells during the gamete formation. The gametes produced by this meiosis, these are haploid, reproductive cell is diploid. Thus, there is a reduction of chromosome number. Chromosome number is reduced to half, and that's why this is called as a reductional type of cell division. In this process, four haploid gametes are produced. Then we shall see the different steps, different sub-stages involved in the process of meiosis. The meiosis first is divided into two stages, meiosis first and second is meiosis second. Meiosis first आणि meiosis second. Meiosis first मध्ये हा diploid cell जो आहे याच्यापासून दोन haploid cells तयार होतात, आणि meiosis second मध्ये या दोन haploid cells पासून चार haploid cells तयार होतात. In the meiosis first, a diploid cell divides, there is formation of two haploid cells. In the meiosis second, these two haploid cells divide and there is formation of four haploid cells or the four haploid gametes. In this case, chromosome number is reduced to half in the daughter cells. That's why this is called as heterotypic type of cell division. This is a heterotypic type of cell division. In this case, the chromosome number in these parent cells, याचे parents हे आहेत, याचे parent हा आहे, तर याच्यामध्ये क्रोमोझोम नंबर हा सेम ठेवला जातो, म्हणून याला म्हणायचं होमोटायपिक टाईप ऑफ सेल डिव्हिजन. हेटरोटायपिक बिकॉज क्रोमोझोम नंबर इन द डॉटर सेल्स इज डिफरंट दॅन द पॅरेंट्स. क्रोमोझोम नंबर इज सेम ॲज दोज ऑफ पॅरेंट्स, सो दिस इज अ होमोटायपिक, दिस इज अ हेटरोटायपिक. We shall see the details of meiosis first. This meiosis first is divided into following phases. First one is prophase first, metaphase first. Anaphase first, and telophase first. Prophase first, metaphase first, anaphase first, and telophase first. So here, meiosis first, it is divided into four stages: prophase first, metaphase first, anaphase first, and telophase first. We shall see the details of prophase first. This prophase first, here up to this, these are the different stages which are occurring in the prophase first. First one is leptotin, second one is zygotin, pachytin, diplotin, and diakinesis. Here, ya paanch sub stages ya prophase first madhe yetat. So this prophase first, it is of longer duration. याला जास्त कालावधी लागतो. It is of longer duration, and significant features peculiar to meiosis. म्हणजे meiosis मध्ये ज्या महत्त्वाच्या घटना घडतात त्या prophase first मध्ये घडतात. Total meiosis मध्ये सगळ्यात महत्त्वाची जी घटना आहे रिकॉम्बिनेशन, जेनेटिक रिकॉम्बिनेशन, तर हे प्रोफेस फर्स्टमध्ये होतं. सो मी इन धिस मेयॉसिस यू विल सी दॅट सिग्निफिकंट फीचर्स पिक्युलियर टू मेयॉसिस दे ऑकर इन द प्रोफेस फर्स्ट. धिस प्रोफेस फर्स्ट जस्ट नाव आय टोल्ड यू इट इज सब डिवायडेड इन टू लेप्टोटीन, झायगोटीन, पॅचिटीन, डिप्लोटीन आणि डायकारिस. वी शॅल सी द leptotin. In this leptotin, first event occurs, volume of nucleus increases. First event is volume of nucleus increases. Second event which occurs, chromosomes become distinct, longer, coiled. Chromosomes become distinct, longer, coiled, and thread-like. In this stage, you can see volume of this nucleus. This is a cell membrane. This is a nuclear membrane. Here, this is a nucleus. Volume of this nucleus increases. Chromosomes become distinct. They become longer. They become coiled, and they will look like threads. Here you can see that these thread-like chromosomes are observed. Another thing is that this is the nucleolus. This is the nuclear membrane. Nucleolus and nuclear membrane, they are intact. The second stage, this is called as zygotin. In this zygotin, you will see that pairing of homologous chromosomes starts. We have, for our convenience, for our understanding, we have considered only a single pair of homologous chromosomes. Homologous chromosomes means these chromosomes are morphologically similar. One comes from the father, other comes from the mother. Means it is paternal, it is maternal. And these are similar in morphology, but they are having different genes. You can see that in the zygotin, synapses starts. There is formation of a synaptonemal complex. Synapsis means pairing of homologous chromosomes. Pairing of homologous chromosomes. Here we have shown here the pairing has started. Here this pairing has started, or we can say that in this zygotin stage, pairing of homologous chromosomes occurs. A pair of homologous chromosome consists of one paternal chromosome, another is maternal chromosome. Here, this pair of homologous chromosomes, this is called as bivalent or tetrad. Here, this pair of homologous chromosomes, this is called as a bivalent or tetrad. So means pairing, synapses. Pairing synapses means pairing. Synapses occurs because of the formation of synaptonemal complex. In this case, the homologous pair of chromosomes having one paternal chromosome, another maternal chromosome. Nucleolus and nuclear membrane, they are intact. The next stage is, this is pachytene. In the pachytene stage, you can see that this chromosome longitudinally splits. म्हणजे असं उभा कट होतो, याचे दोन भाग तयार होतात, याला म्हणायचं क्रोमॅटिड्स. हिअर दिस रेड वन वी उच्च शोन, इट प्रोड्युसेस टू क्रोमॅटिड्स. इट स्प्लिट्स लॉन्जिट्युडनली टू प्रोड्यूस टू क्रोमॅटिड्स. दिस मॅटर्नल क्रोमोझोम ऑल्सो स्प्लिट्स लॉन्जिट्युडनली अँड देर इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ टू क्रोमॅटिड्स. दीज क्रोमॅटिड्स आर अटॅच टू द कॉमन सेंट्रोमियर. म्हणजे हे दोन क्रोमॅटिड्स या सेंट्रोमियरला अटॅच झालेले आहेत. हे दोन सॉरी क्रोमॅटिड्स हे दोन क्रोमॅटिड्स या कॉमन सेंट्रोमियरला अटॅच झालेले आहेत. दिस इज द फर्स्ट इव्हेंट. इन द सेकंड इव्हेंट यू कॅन सी दॅट देर इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए क्रॉस लाईक स्ट्रक्चर. हिअर देर इज फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ए क्रॉस लाईक फिगर बिटवीन द नॉन सिस्टर क्रोमॅटिड्स. नॉन सिस्टर मीन्स व्हॉट? दीज टू क्रोमॅटिड्स आर सिस्टर क्रोमॅटिड्स. These two are sister chromatids and these two are non-sister chromatids. Between the non-sister chromatids, there is formation of a cross-shaped structure. This is called as chiasmata. This structure is called as chiasmata. So here, what happens during the gamete formation? You can see that in the beginning, these segments break. Segments of the chromatids, they break. After breaking, this joins with this and this joins with this. During the chiasma, at the chiasma formation, at the time of chiasma formation, the breaking of these chromatids takes place, segments of the chromatids takes place, and there is an exchange of chromatids. Exchange of segments of the chromatids, we can see that to this paternal chromosome, the segment of maternal chromosome is attached. To this maternal chromosome, the segment of this paternal chromosome is attached. So these are the two chiasmata which we have shown in this case. Means exchange of chromatid segments takes place. So this is a very important step in the process of meiosis, pachytene. In the pachytene, the chromosome splits vertically to form two chromatids. These are two chromatids of a paternal chromosome. These two are the chromatids of a maternal chromosome. There is formation of a cross-like structure. This is called as chiasma. At the place of chiasma, the segments of chromosome break and there is exchange of chromatid segments. Means to this chromosome, this segment is attached. To this chromosome, this segment is attached. Means there is exchange of chromatid segments. So this is called as a crossing over. This is called as a crossing over or genetic recombination. This is called as genetic recombination. After that, next step is diploty. During the diploty stage, you can see that repulsion of these chromosomes starts. म्हणजे एकमेकापासून दूर जायला सुरुवात होते. So, in the diploid stage, the synapsed chromosomes, paired chromosomes, they repel, they try to go away from each other. Here you can see that centromere here is going away from each other, and then these are attached only at the chiasmata. So this occurs in the diploid stage, and in this stage there is a disappearance of synaptonemal complex. At this place, synaptonemal complex was formed in the zygote stage, pairing occurs. At this place, synaptonemal complex disappears. In the next step, diakinesis. During the diakinesis, you can see that there is a movement of this chiasmata. This chiasma move towards the ends. Then we shall say how it moves. Suppose this is a chiasma. It moves like this. This is called as terminalization of chiasma. this chiasma move towards the ends. This chiasma moves towards the ends. Here, this is called as a zipper fashion. So here, this cross-like figure moves like this, and these chromosomes, these are separated. This is called as terminalization of chiasmata. At this stage also, nucleolus and nuclear membrane are intact. In the diakinesis stage, you can see that terminalization is completed. The chromosomes, these chromosomes are separated. You can see that in these chromosomes, if you see this chromosome, it has a some part of maternal chromosome, this part. If you see this maternal chromosome, this has a some part of this paternal chromosomes. Means segments of chromatids have been exchanged, means genes have been exchanged. Manje yachyavarti tya chromosomes varti asnare gene te sudha ya thikani exchange zalele ahet. So in this case, in the diakinesis, there is a terminalization of chiasmata. Here this chiasmata moves towards the ends, and these two chromosomes are separated in the diakinesis. This is called as terminalization of chiasmata. At this stage, nucleolus disappears, nuclear membrane also disappears. In the diakinesis, chromosomes have been separated, nucleolus disappears, and nuclear membrane also disappears. At this stage, spindle formation starts, spindle fiber formation starts. So these are the spindle fibers. So up to this diakinesis, this is prophase first. In the metaphase first, you can see these chromosomes which are formed, these are arranged on the equatorial line. This is the equatorial line. On this equatorial line, these are arranged. Here, these are arranged in a such a manner that centromeres are directed towards the poles, and these arms are directed towards the equator. Spindle fibers are formed. These spindle fibers are attached to the centromeres of these chromosomes. Here, there are two chromosomes. These chromosomes are arranged on the equatorial line. These are arranged in such a manner that centromeres are directed towards the poles and arms are directed towards the equator. Spindle fibers are formed from the centrioles. These are attached to the centromeres of these chromosomes. So this is the metaphase, first stage of meiosis first. तिसरी जी स्टेज आहे मेओसिस फर्स्ट मध्ये ती आहे ती एनाफेज फर्स्ट. इन दिस एनाफेज फर्स्ट यू विल सी दॅट द क्रोमोझोम्स दीज आर पुल्ड अपार्ट टुवर्ड द अपोजिट पोल्स. हियर वी हॅव सीन दॅट सेंट्रोमियर इज अटॅच्ड टू द पोल्स ऑर सेंट्रिओल्स, अँड बिकॉज ऑफ द शॉर्टनिंग ऑफ द स्पिंडल फायबर्स दीज क्रोमोझोम्स आर पुल्ड अपार्ट टुवर्ड द opposite poles. In this anaphase, chromosomes are pulled apart. Separation of these chromosomes, separation of the chromosome, this is called as disjunction. In this case, the chromatids have been not separated. There is no division of the centromere. So each centromere has attached two chromatids. Thus, these chromosomes, these are pulled apart toward the opposite poles. This is the disjunction. At this stage, there is a reduction in the chromosome number. Pudchi ji stage hai, this is telophase first. In the telophase first, these chromosomes reach the opposite poles. This group of chromosomes, we have shown single, but there is a group of chromosomes. This group of chromosomes reaches the opposite poles. After reaching the pole, next stage starts. This is a telophase first. In the anaphase, chromosomes are pulled apart, reaching the poles. And in the telophase, these chromosomes have restored the opposite poles. The chromosomes elongate. They form thread-like structures. Chromosomes elongate. They are forming a thread-like structure. Around each group of the chromosome, there is formation of a nuclear membrane. There is formation of a nucleus in each group of the chromosomes. Thus, there is formation of two haploid daughter nuclei. These are haploid. chromosome number is reduced. If you compare the chromosome number of these daughter nuclei with the nucleus of the parent, you will see that chromosome number is reduced. This is the telophase. Next one is the cytokinesis. After telophase, up to the telophase, from prophase first up to the telophase, this is called as karyokinesis. Karyokinesis means division of nucleus. Cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. Here there is formation of a cell plate. Means there is a division of cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is divided. Thus, there is formation of two daughter cells. These are two daughter nuclei. After the formation of cell plate, there is formation of two daughter cells. At this stage, meiosis first ends. The next phase starts. This is the meiosis second. In the meiosis first, we have seen prophase first, which is of longer duration, divided into leptotenes, zygotene, pachytene, diplotene, and dikinase. Second one is the metaphase, chromosomes are arranged at the equator. In the anaphase, chromosomes are pulled apart because of shortening of spindle fibers, and thus there is a division of chromosomes. In the telophase, haploid number of chromosomes goes to the opposite poles, reaches to the opposite poles. There is formation of a nuclear membrane around each group of the chromosomes. There is formation of a nucleolus, and thus there is formation of two daughter nuclei. After that, cytokinesis takes place, means the division of cytoplasm, and thus two daughter nuclei are formed. These two daughter nuclei are haploid, having half number of the chromosomes as that of the parents. The next one is the meiosis second. This is the meiosis first. This is the meiosis second. In the meiosis second division, here each cell undergoes the meiosis second. Here we are considering this cell. This cell also proceeds in the same manner. If you consider this cell, you can see here, this is a chromosome. We have considered single chromosome for our convenience at this place. In the beginning, we have considered two chromosomes. Here, haploid cell is formed, that's why there is a single chromosome. In the prophase first, you can see that there is a disappearance of nucleolus and there is disappearance of nuclear membrane. Here there is a nuclear membrane, here there is no nuclear membrane. Means nuclear membrane has disappeared, nucleolus also disappearing. Then afterwards, this is a prophase, and in this prophase we can see that the chromosomes become distinct with two chromatids. Each chromosome has two chromatids, so chromosomes become distinct with two chromatids. Centriole divides. Here there is a centriole in the cytoplasm. It divides and goes to the opposite poles. Then daughter, here you can see the daughter cells which are produced. One undergoes this type of division. This also goes to under this type of division. The prophase first, where these chromosomes are clear or the distinct, nuclear membrane disappeared, nucleolus also disappearing. Then afterwards, this cell enters the metaphase second. In the metaphase second, you can see that these chromosomes are arranged on the equatorial line. Chromosomes are arranged on the equatorial line. And then you can see that this centromere splits. Centromere splits, and now each chromatid has a separate centromere. This chromatid has a separate centromere. Now it is called as chromosome. Not the chromatid, but chromosome. This chromatid becomes a chromosome. Centromere splits. Each chromatid has a separate centromere. Thus, this chromatid is called as a chromosome. There is formation of spindle fibers. The spindle fibers are attached to the centromeres of the chromosomes. In the metaphase, chromosomes are arranged on the equatorial line. Spindle fibers are formed. These are attached to the centromeres. This is the metaphase second. then starts the anaphase second. In the anaphase second, because of shortening of the spindle fibers, here these are the spindle fibers, because of the shortening of the spindle fibers, these sister chromosomes, these are pulled apart. This goes to, this is traveling towards this pole, this is traveling towards this pole. Here you can see this chromosome goes towards this pole, this chromosome is going toward the upper pole. Thus, there is a movement of chromosomes or pulling apart of the chromosomes because of the spindle fibers. In the telophase, these chromosomes reach to the opposite poles. These chromosomes have reached over the opposite poles. Around each group of the chromosome, there is formation of a nuclear membrane. In each group of this chromosome, there is formation of a nucleolus. Thus, there is formation of a daughter nucleus. Around this group of the chromosomes, there is formation of a nuclear membrane. There is formation of a nucleolus. And thus, a daughter nucleus is formed. So, two daughter nuclei are formed in this manner. This is the telophase second. The next stage after telophase, this is the cytokinesis. Pratyek cell division mhanje don major steps astat. Pahili je ahe ti karyokinesis means division of nucleus. Nucleus cha division hoto tyala mhanayche karyokinesis. Ani next step ahe tyala mhanayche cytokinesis mhanje division of cytoplasm. In this case, there is formation of a cell plate between these two daughter nuclei. Now, cytoplasm has divided and there is formation of two daughter cells. Similarly, this cell also goes or undergoes the meiosis second. This also produces these two cells. So, this meiosis second, it is similar to the mitosis. This cell, which is produced in the telophase first, undergoes the meiosis second. Meiosis second is similar to the mitosis. In this case, chromosomes become distinct. Each chromosome has two sister chromatids attached to the common centromere. Nuclear membrane and nucleolus, they disappear. Chromosomes are arranged on the equatorial line. There is formation of spindle fibers from the poles. Spindle fibers are attached to the centromeres of the chromosomes. This centromere divides and each chromatid has a separate centromere. So, these are called chromosomes. Then cell enters the anaphase. In the anaphase, because of the shortening of the spindle fibers, chromosomes are pulled apart toward the opposite poles. In the telophase, you can see these chromosomes have reached the opposite poles. After reaching the poles, around each group of the chromosomes, there is formation of a nuclear membrane and the nucleolus. Thus, two daughter nuclei are formed. This is a telophase second. Now, these chromosomes, which were thick in the anaphase, metaphase, etc., they elongate and they are observed as a, they are forming a fiber-like structure. Then, there is formation of a next stage. This is called as cytokinesis. Cytokinesis means division of cytoplasm. Here there is formation of a cell plate or there is formation of a constriction like this in the animals, and these two nuclei have been divided, thus forming two daughter cells. This cell produces two daughter cells. This cell also produces two daughter cells. Thus, four daughter cells are produced at the end of meiotic division. If a single diploid cell undergoes the process of meiosis, it produces four haploid cells. Then we shall see how this occurs. Here in the first meiotic division, there is formation of two haploid cells. In the second meiotic division, each cell produces again two daughter cells. This is haploid, this is haploid, this is haploid, this is haploid. Thus, from a single cell, this is M second or meiosis second. In the meiosis first, two haploid cells are produced. Here there is a reduction of chromosome number. This is called a heterotypic cell division. Here in the meiosis second, each haploid cell produces two haploid cells. This also produces two haploid cells. It is similar to the mitosis. This is called as homotypic cell division. Then we shall see the significance of meiosis. Why meiosis is important to the organism? First important significance of meiosis is that meiotic division produces haploid gametes. Meiotic division or meiotic type of cell division, it produces haploid gametes. Just now we have seen that these four haploid cells are produced by the process of meiosis. Each develops into the gamete. Thus, female reproductive cell undergoes the process of meiosis. It produces four haploid gametes. This is the first significance. If suppose there is no meiosis, what will happen, we shall see. If suppose there is a diploid organism, if there is no meiosis, means there is no reduction in the chromosome number. No reduction in the chromosome number. If suppose these are the gametes, these gametes four fuse together, there is formation of four an organism. Here, this organism divides by mitosis. There is no meiosis, just now we have seen. Again, if they fuse together, there is formation of 18 number of the chromosomes. Thus, chromosome number will go on increasing in the cell. This will lead to the abnormalities in the organism, or this is called as monstrosities. This is called as monstrosities or abnormal forms. The cell having a large number of chromosomes, abnormal number of the chromosomes, this is called monstrosities, or these are the abnormal forms. The next significance of this meiosis maintains a constant chromosome number. Constant number of the chromosomes in a species across the generations. After the large number of generations, chromosome number is kept constant. How it is, you can see. Suppose this is a diploid organism. This produces haploid gametes. These gametes fuse together, this formation of diploid organism. This produces haploid gametes. This fuse together, there is formation of a diploid organism. Thus, chromosome number is kept constant across the many generations. This is the next significance. Another significance of this meiosis is because of the crossing over. Just now we have seen that there is exchange of chromatid segments. This is called as crossing over. Due to the crossing over, there is a genetic recombination. There is a genetic recombination. Then we shall see how this is. You can see this blue part. This blue part is from this blue chromosome. It will have different genes. It will have different genes. Means there is a mixing or a recombination of genetic material. And this recombination leads to the variation. This leads to the variation. Means the genetic material is exchanged. This is called as a genetic recombination. And because of the recombination, the variation is formed, and variation is the raw material for the process of evolution. Genetic recombination, that is variation. बदल होतो आणि हा जो बदल आहे दिस इज ए रॉ मटेरियल फॉर इव्होल्युशन उत्क्रांतीसाठी हे अत्यावश्यक आहे. दिस इज अबाउट द मियोसिस सेकंड.